Looking for smart in-wall switches to enhance your smart home? Today we're going to look at the new Z-Wave Plus smart switches from GE and Leviton, and the new kid on the block, which is Zooz. Stay tuned. This video is not a paid endorsement, and I receive no compensation for making this video. All product links in the description below are affiliate links, and I may receive commissions if you purchase products from these links. Some of the switches shown in this video were provided to me for free from the manufacturer. However, the video should not be considered an endorsement for any of these products. Hi again, John Stone, the DIY smart home guy on the channel that's all about helping you make intelligent home automation decisions for your affordable smart home. And if you're looking for an in-wall smart switch, this video is for you. Last year, I made a similar video about the GE and Leviton Z-Wave switches and included the Lutron Caseta switch for good measure. Since GE and Leviton have released Z-Wave Plus versions, I decided to update the video. There's new stuff going on, so even if you've watched the old video, it's worth your time to see what's new, mainly because there's this new kid on the block. The folks over at thesmartesthouse.com were kind enough to send over their entire line of Zooz Z-Wave Plus smart in-wall switches. Zooz is the house brand for thesmartesthouse.com, and so far, these switches seem pretty cool. They also have a number of other products that you can check out on their website. It's also important to note that since my last video, Leviton has updated their switch design, which makes me pretty happy. In short, the new design encompasses a true rocker panel instead of the old switch that was pretty much stuck spring-loaded in the on position, and to turn the switch on and off, you always had to push down to the off position. And in case you're wondering, let's get into why Z-Wave Plus is better than regular old Z-Wave. I left a link to a video that goes into more detail about Z-Wave Plus in the description, but in short, Z-Wave Plus is comprised of a new Z-Wave standard and a new chip. The chip offers a 67% improvement in range, which makes your mesh network stronger. It also boasts a 50% increase in battery life and a 250% increase in bandwidth. These features should help improve the response speed of the device as well as improve the signal reliability. Now, I don't plan to run out and change all of my normal Z-Wave switches all at once, but I do plan to replace them over time. Each of these switches cost between $30 and $45, so let's break down the prices as found on a popular shopping website. So when we're looking at the standard paddle style switch for the on-off, you can find the Zooz paddle switches for about $33, the GE's for $38, the Leviton's for $45. That Lutron switch is usually going to be $50 to $60, so I put it down for $55. Now all three of these have a three-way on-off capability, but the nice thing about that Zooz switch is you can use a regular three-way switch as the add-on switch. Now what that means is for the GE's and the Leviton, you're going to be paying anywhere from $10 to $18 for that add-on capability, where with the Zooz, you can just reuse that three-way switch to make your three-way configuration with the Zooz smart switch. On the Lutron side, you're going to need a Pico remote if you want a three-way configuration. When we look at those paddle dimmers, those are a little bit more expensive. Even on the Zooz side, you're going to find that Zooz for about $40. GE dimmer $38, Leviton around $45, and that Lutron, and those prices stay pretty consistent. Now, again, you're going to need the add-on switch. For all of these other switches, you don't need one with the Zooz. However, because you're using a regular three-way switch, you're not going to get the dimming capability out of that secondary switch box. So the Zooz on the primary one will be the only one that allow you to do the dimming. You're just going to hold it down and it's going to turn the brightness of the light up. Hold it down, turn the brightness down. But on the secondary side, this is still only going to turn it off and on. Now the nice thing about this is, when you turn it on from the remote switch, it will remember the last dim position. But if you turn it on and it's not bright enough, you are going to need to go over to the other switch and turn the switch up manually, or you're going to need to do it from an app or from your Amazon Alexa or Google Home. Now when you look at these switches side by side, they're all going to look pretty similar. Some minor differences are going to be the way the indicator light comes in here. I can't find an indicator light on this particular Leviton model, but the Zooz and that GE switch look pretty similar. Both the Zooz and the GE have the fins on the side here. In case you don't know, that's what these little things here are, is their heatsink fins. If you put these next to each other into a wall box, you're going to need to remove those fins so everything fits in there just fine. So that's that. The Leviton switch does not have the heatsink fins on the side. It looks like they found another way to solve their heat problem. When we turn these things over, again, the GE and the Zooz are gonna look pretty similar, and the Leviton does look different, and you have more of the little vent slots there. These are, again, are all Z-Wave Plus switches, and they're all pretty nice.
Let's rock them over on the side real quick and just look at the profile of those rocker switches. So you can see the lowest profile of them all is pretty much on that Zooz right here. It's got a nice action to it. It's kind of firm to the touch. That GE switch, it's a little more proud of the bezel than that Zooz is. And again, it's kind of firm to the touch. And that Leviton switch, but it's got a nice light touch to it. Very responsive, you don't have to push it real hard, so it's not the big positive action that you have to get on the Zooz and the GE switch. But all in all, these are all three really nice Z-Wave Plus in-wall switches.
As I mentioned, thesmartesthouse.com sent me these switches for free in hopes that I would mention their website. I haven't decided if I will or not. That was creepy. But anyway, there is a link to thesmartesthouse.com in the description below. They were also nice enough to provide a coupon code for DIY Smart Home Guy channel supporters. This coupon will get you 10% off of purchased products. You can find the coupon code over on my Patreon page. That's patreon.com/DIY Smart Home Guy. Now the Zooz switches come in these normal Decora or paddle style switches as we were showing you earlier. And they also have these toggle style switches, and these are available as both dimming and non-dimming. One of the things that people complain about a little bit, and this is with all of the toggle style smart switches, not just the Zooz, is that these things stick straight out. And some people don't like that. They're just used to all their life seeing these things at that angle, and they don't like the fact that it sits there in the middle. But the paddle switches, you know, these rest in the center also, but because there's such a low profile there, you don't really tend to notice that they rest in that center configuration as much. And again, when it comes to that three-way switch configuration, not needing that add-on switch can be a big deal to some people. As Edward recently asked, if I use a Z-Wave smart switch, do I need an add-on switch? This is one of the most popular questions on my three-way switch installation video. And if you're using a GE, Leviton, or Lutron switch, the answer is yes. You'll need to spend an extra $15 to $20 on a special add-on switch or Pico remote. But that's not the case with the Zooz in-wall switches. They've designed their switches to work with a normal three-way switch in the auxiliary box, meaning the box that doesn't have the smart switch. Now take note, you'll need to rewire the regular three-way switch, but you don't need to purchase an add-on. I'll be showing you how to wire the Zooz in a three-way application in an upcoming video. So now's a good time to subscribe. You'll also want to slap that bell icon to be notified when new videos are released or if I stream a live broadcast. Another popular question that I get is, do I need a neutral wire to make this switch work? For the Zooz, GE, and Leviton switches, the answer is absolutely yes. Now I've seen advice on some message boards that recommend using a bare ground wire in place of the neutral wire if you don't have the white neutral, but I'm not really going to recommend that here. If you're absolutely sure that you don't have a neutral, you may want to check out the Lutron Caseta line of switches. I did a video that installed this switch not too long ago. You'll recognize this switch as the one that I use to control my bar light. It's a great switch and it gets pretty good reviews. So let's talk about how to get this Zooz installed into the SmartThings app. When you go to bring this thing into your SmartThings or Wink Hub, you'll notice that the instructions tell you to turn the switch off, then on, then off. This is a no-go according to Zooz. The proper way to do this is to tap on the switch three times in the up position within a couple of seconds. So let's get this into the SmartThings app. So we're gonna come over and we're gonna hit that little plus right there in the upper right hand corner. Okay, so we tap that up three times and you can see that the light came on. That's annoying. And that brought it in as a Z-Wave dimmer. So we'll select that and we'll rename that. Okay, so we're gonna go in, we're gonna look at that dimmer. Right off the bat, you can see that you have on and off, and you can see that that brightness level came up to the last level that it was set at. And you can just swipe that around on the app and get that down pretty low. So let's see how low we can get it. Sometimes how low the light will go is a function of the light bulb more than it is the switch or the app. Okay, and removing it should be just as easy. Let's go into that Zooz dimmer there, and this time we're going up into settings. And we're just gonna say remove. And we'll go tap that three times. This time I did it three times in the down position and it has been removed. There you go.
Okay, so let's go over to the Wink app and we'll do the same thing. Okay, so on the Wink Hub, we're gonna follow the same process. This time we're gonna go down to our Add a Device, scroll down here to Lights, and you won't see the Zooz on here. I'm gonna have a little bit of fun. I'm just gonna actually pick the GE in wall smart dimmer just for fun. Connect now, and we're gonna tap up three times on the top of that switch. And we have a success. Done. So that's the thing, I believe personally that the way Wink does this is as long as the device is similar to the one you're trying to pair, it's gonna bring it in just fine. So you don't have to worry about it too much. We could have just used a generic Z-Wave switch and that should have worked as well. But in this case, I just wanted to try using the GE and it did fine. So we'll bring that in. There it is. So it's the one called light bulb. We are going to turn that light bulb off and it's gonna ramp down. Now, the folks over at Zooz also told me that at this time you cannot control the ramp rate of that switch. However, they are working on a firmware update to allow you to do that. So we'll be looking for that very soon as well. But again, same features that you'd have here in the Wink Hub. Turn it off and on, as well as control that brightness level. So I gotta admit, the last product that had me this excited was the Inovelli 2-channel plug-in module. So it's definitely worth checking out. If it passes my lab burn-in test, this is my new go-to wall switch, especially considering the price. And don't forget to check out my Patreon page for the 10% off coupon code. And thanks again to thesmartesthouse.com for donating these switches for this video. For more reviews, tips, and smart home products, visit azhb.com. Don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to click like. Over here are a couple of other videos that you might enjoy. And thanks to all of you that already support me over on patreon.com/DIY Smart Home Guy. Until next time. Cheers. That was creepy.